Alright everyone, Buzz Killington bringing you a BuzzCast first, being another game, on a brand new map. This map I believe is called Bamboo Weeds or something catchy like that, and is the first map that I've cast from the newly released Command Post R14 version of the game. So let's have a look, see what happens, and get the game underway, and we'll also check out the map and see what it has to offer. So starting over here in the bottom left as the green GDI faction, we have Dvmir with his spike on the top bottom left corner there, and as the pink we have pink marked Kane, we have Ekko. So, and he has a corresponding spike on top right. As you can see, safe spikes, no big deal. Having a quick look around the map, we have a second spike here for each player. Both relatively safe. It's possible a buzzer could make it to that before the engineer makes it there, but I doubt it, especially if you deploy your barracks further forward. We have an EMP control center on each side. Quite interesting, very open map this. And yep, refinery, there's no rushing coming out yet. We have Ekko has sending his, not microing his engineer particularly well. He's perhaps lucky that a scout didn't get there. This provides some interesting cover here, so it's quite difficult to see what's going on and where the units are. Especially depending on your colour, so green might be a very useful colour on this particular map. All spikes captured by all sides. Nice little garrisonable structure right there, and there should be a corresponding one there. There it is. So it would seem that you expand war factories out. Eco build by the looks of it. Let's just have a quick look. Yep, eco build from both sides at the moment, so we can take a quick second to look around. Logical expansion point for the top player is anti-clockwise to this point, and then to here. A little bit of rock feature in the middle there, but decent sized Tiberium fields. And logically anti-clockwise for the corresponding player as well. Not very many rushing opportunities on this map. It's a very open map, so it's going to favour Nod, Bike Buggy, GDI Mass Pit, Screen Descents are going to have a lot of space. Well, this checkpoint here, they could come through, they could also loop through anywhere along here. You've got to keep this area well scouted. And as we can see here, Ekko is indeed, he's got three power plants, he's immediately expanding this way. From the look that you could expand on two or even one, that's a relatively not too far an expansion distance. He's expanding quite, he's gone quite a way there. Just deployed a little bit later than he needed to. Dvmir is now set up, he already has his construction underway. Slightly different buildings on each side, not quite symmetrical, but hey. No, neither one has gone for their EMP control center, perhaps something they'd want to do a bit later on. Nice garrison of this structure. The structure here provides a handy little defense, and we see double war factory coming out from Dvmir, so we could see some pit aggression from him. We'll see what we'll get in a moment. What are we getting from Ekko? Ekko has gone Ekko. As I was saying, these buildings are good defensive structures to protect your expansion field. I imagine he's now going to build a rocket man to go into there. A rocket man. But yeah. Well, he's built a second war factory and he's not really going very aggressive with it. So perhaps Ekko, a refinery first, might have been the way to go here. He's just building a harvester. But his refinery isn't done yet. Rally point was a bit weird there too. But he's basically dropped a foxhole. He's making sure he's got good scouting. Ah, here we go. He got some. Soon I didn't notice the pit, see what I mean about the green? Very hard to spot. Double war factory out now, we do have a scorpion tank out. They will get a harvest to kill here. Unless he does some very fancy microing. Is he actually going to be able to save it? No, there's no way. Just got it there. Well, you can see the colour dip, the colour issues there. People are definitely, the Canier players are definitely going to be picking green for this particular map. Very hard to spot what's coming. Pink stands out a mile away. But we have a decent sized Scorp force. No dozer blades. Hand of Nod down. We do have rockets and mock out as defensive. Oh, Steel Talons. Why did I think he was GDI? Oh, I never found his faction. Sorry, it's Steel Talons. But in any case, makes no difference. He's got a good rush off, got a harvest to kill, and now he has the Titans out to defend. These Scorps are going to get nothing done, certainly without their Dozer Blades. Two refineries down for Dvmir in the meantime, and he is spamming out those Titans from his double war factory at the moment. See, there's an avenue for attack down here, which is completely undefended by the Titans at the moment. If he has bikes around there, he can get a good kill. So there's definitely options for aggression on the first field. Scorps are retreating, single Titan coming after for a little look-see. Those six should be able to focus it down, assuming he knows it's there, which he will shortly. What have we got over here? We have a double refinery down for Ekko as well. There's some bikes. We're going to get some bike aggression out of him. He's perhaps going to... Where did that radar scan come down? Right there, all he's spotting is his Ekko. There's tier 2. Radar jammer comes down. So he is going to see what's going on. Where are the bikes off to? Okay. Perhaps not where I would have put them. I mean, he needs to get south. Get south down here, although we do have a Titan sneaking around. This is crafty stuff. Yep, the bikes are now heading south, planning to loop round and clockwise and get some damage done. But that Titan has now been must have been spotted. Yep, we'll rip that, but now he knows that the bikes are out. In the meantime, we have mass pit and Titan pushing in. Well, mass pit and a few escorting Titans pushing in. The infantry here will be useful against this. The Scorps are repositioning quickly. Cut them off. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Titans. We need to get a little bit more aggressive there. And the mine drop hits. Hits 2 and a pit will drive straight through it. So that's decent. A little bit of waste, really. And we have an air out from him as well. Hammerheads. 3 hammerheads right now. But there's too much rocket troops here. That should be enough to focus them down. Pits are coming in. Got a harvest to kill. Scorps are working tirelessly to focus him down. Oh, that harvester should have been microed around a refinery. He could have been saved. We have incoming more hammerheads. Somehow they're still alive. Where is this tier 2? Where is this base defense? There we go. Are we going to get a kill? No. Every one of the hammerheads escapes. Dvmir basically suiciding his troops in. He's getting a lot of damage done here. But Ekko now has the situation under control. Those Titans will eventually fall. Is this... He really needs to do something. If he loses that harvester, that's just going to be embarrassing. That Titan appears to be completely stuck in place. Oh no, it is moving. Oh no. I thought he'd squashed that. I thought he'd driven right under its feet, but no. And in the meantime, he has taken the opportunity. Oh, bloody hell. Damn it. I was so preoccupied with the match, with the fight going on up there, I nearly missed the fact that his MCV was almost completely focused down. That must have been where the bikes were. Got some powerful work done there, but they managed to save it. We have an engineer out. Hello, we've got some aggression from Ekko now, rather than using his natural expansion. Second MCV, he is going to go and put some pressure on Dvmir. Engineer used to repair the MCV back up to full health. Pits are buzzing about, keeping a good eye out here. 4 hammerheads. War factory sold off. We have more hammerheads incoming. 5 now. Are there more on the way? Not right now. AP ammo is done for him. And here comes the push. Perhaps deployed a little bit far back for his MCV, but he is concerned with those hammerheads. The problem is the pits can just sweep in. What does he have to support it? He doesn't have anything. Is the answer there? Hammerheads have simply gone somewhere else. Single Venom coming in for reasons that escape me. The hammerheads have come for a little look-see. One base defense. Oh, God. Did they get a harvester kill out of that? Wow. That was good work there. They got a harvester kill. Managed to catch Ekko completely out of position once again. Sight is not clear what this... Oh, there we go. We've got an obelisk down now. Yeah, that will force the harvester to retreat, though it should get away. He should start targeting down that MCV now, but a simple barracks drop with engineers will keep that MCV alive for a long time. Pitbull's pushing in, and once more Ekko is forced on a defensive. As an odd player, he wants to be on the attack. And he's just not being given the opportunity. Dvmir is determined to keep him on the back foot, and it's working pretty well. Got the hammerheads here. There's still not enough anti-air base defenses here to support this. He needs to drop the base defenses. He does have tip core missile, but he only has one base defense, and all they have to do is move out of range. Obelisk is targeting down the MCV. Oh, he's targeting down the harvester now. He should get a kill there. sell off the MCV, but he has spotted that Redeemer engineering facility. Scorps are moving to make sure it doesn't get taken out. Those pits, if the Scorps weren't there, the pits could have pushed in and probably taken it down in time, but it looks like the Redeemer is going to be deploying in a very unusual place. He needs more base defenses here. He has so much stuff here. The Hammerheads could come in and completely overwhelm him. But instead they're targeting down the Scorps. And where is that MCV going? That MCV is pulled right out of position. But the Scorps are... Oh, the Scorps perhaps should have played defense until Redeemer got out. But the Redeemer is not done yet. Perhaps if Dvmir pushes in, he could even take out the facility. The potential is there. He needs to recognize it. He needs to push quickly. Ekko is starved for cash right now. Single Titan making a nuisance of itself, almost taking out the hand of Nod. Long distance leeching for these harvesters here. The question is he going to be allowed to get his Redeemer out? He doesn't have the funds. He doesn't have the funds to get it out. He's absolutely stalled out. This harvest is doing nothing. This is a potential disaster in the making for Ekko here. He really, really, really needs to get that Redeemer out. But he's lost his Venom. The Pitbulls are pushing in. Stealth tanks against Pitbulls. That is not a good trade for him. Well, there we go. That went as well as could be expected. Ah, the Redeemer is still not out. The Redeemer is still not out. Ekko is completely starved out for money. He's noticed that Harvester isn't doing its job now. He's building Harvesters back here. No wonder he can't get the Redeemer out. He needs to concentrate on that. Scorpion goes down and he's just feeding experience points to that Titan right now. Ekko is really all over the place at the moment. Dvmir has expanded to Ekko's expansion, which is a logical one, and he will secure it. What are the options here? We've got Harvesters moving across. There we go, finally. The Redeemer has risen, but the action has moved away to the northwest, so now the Redeemer is completely out of position. Ooh, down goes the power plant. What is going on here? I mean, Ekko needs to get this situation under control quickly. He needs a couple of rockets to be enough to deal with that. Single base defense to deal with the infantry. The Hammerheads, where are the Hammerheads? There's two there. Is he working to build more? Not right now. What's going on back here? The Redeemer is undefended. The Redeemer doesn't have a garrison. It has no engineer. He needs an engineer in that, really. In the meantime, Dvmir has completely taken this field. Completely taking control of it, rather. What's going on over here? The little scout coming in. He will see there's no eco here. Oh, hell of light. He's got a refinery down at last. So scout coming off. You need an engineer in that, buddy. You can't replace any losses from it. Is that EMP grenades? No, he doesn't have it researched quite yet. What are we going to see coming out of here? Stealth tanks. He does need to do some damage to Dvmir fast. Dvmir does have double refinery on his expansion. He could just use that stealth tank to run those over. That probably might be the best idea. Reinforcements coming in. Have they dropped yet? They have not deployed as yet. He's going to come over here, put some pressure on this base, but not convinced that's the best course of action with the Redeemer sitting right there. He can't have failed to notice that. That Redeemer needs to redeploy right now. It'd be just embarrassing to lose a harvester to that. Two pits, two Wolverines. What is the Redeemer doing? Ekko is not paying attention. The Redeemer is just sitting there. Oh, he's noticed it now, but oh dear. Oh, it's just bad. It's bad. He's going to lose a harvester there. The MP control center strikes the Redeemer engineering facility. Hits. Well, it doesn't really hit anything. It takes a stealth for that one. There we are, a little bit of EMP, but might not be enough to save that harvester. In fact, I'm damn sure it won't be. Down that goes. That's just careless from Ekko. He shouldn't have allowed that to happen. The Redeemer is here. It will clean up the rest of the units. There we go. This one. There we are. The Wolverine goes down. He needs a hand of Nod. He needs engineers inside that. He needs to stealth. He needs to do a lot of things. He needs to get back into this game. What is he going to do? Happening. The Venom's Ekko is very pissed off at this patch of ground. Nope, not anymore. Alright, that's that's definitely something that happened. Okay, we have a war factory has come down. He has two. He does have his two refinery. He has a war factory down here. War factory and redeemer engine facility. I'm not convinced he needs that. He has nothing up here to stop this, these titans. Why does he? He needs a base defense down here. He needs something. This titan is gonna was looking for a harvester kill. He's not gonna find it. Redeemer still doesn't have anything in it, but look at the size of this hammerhead force. The venoms are here, they will get some damage done, but not enough to save the harvesters. One falls. It's the second harvester going for. Pitbulls should target it down, but that was good work there. The stealth's absolutely saved his bacon there. The pitbulls are in retreat, but Ekko continues to take losses. Continues to be put on the defensive. Dvmir just has complete control of this game at the moment. That Titan is not doing much. Base defense was sold off. So of course now there are no base defenses protecting this. He doesn't need double MCV. Ekko should sell one of his MCVs off. He's really not getting anywhere with them. Okay, finally we're going to see something garrisoning up this Redeemer. Going to be end double engineer probably. Oh, there we go. Yeah, the Redeemer's off on a walk, though. The engineer's going to have to run to catch him. Yeah, both of them are just... No, the Redeemer's gone. The Redeemer's gone. His garrison's over there. I can only assume Ekko just isn't trying his best. He's just testing the new map because this is not the standard gameplay you really expect from him. Why did that come down when this pitbull's here? I can only assume he misclicked that. The two engineers are there. The Redeemer's plodding over there. It's never going to get there in time. He needs bike buggy on a map like this. He needs bike buggy or he needs scorps. Something that can react quicker than this. Right now he's being pulled apart all over the place. He got a pitbull kill. Oh, there's his bikes. Finally, he does have bikes. The engineers have noticed that they are nowhere near the thing they're supposed to be garrisoning. So they're off on a little stroll. More reinforcements coming in. This time there are a butt-ton of venoms and they're about to fly right into them. So that did not go at all well. The venoms are going to hunt that down. One, two. Are they even going to get to land? Oh no, they are going to get to land. Third dies. And all the pitbull survives. Pitbull survives. Could you perhaps... Alright, that was interesting. I'm assuming they got confused between the air unit and its actual cargo, but in any case, we've got pits pushing in now. There are tip core bikes here, but they weren't ready. Ekko was not ready for it. Dvmir is just pulling him apart here, it seems. It's really hard to see how Ekko can get back into this. He's having to constantly move about on this map. It must be a great new map to him. What? Why is that harvester there? I don't know why that harvester was there. It's now dead. It will now be dead shortly anyway. Pitbulls are getting cleaned up by the bikes redeploying from this side. Redeemer is just being used defensively. It's not a good use for it. Some aggression needs to be put on this base here. Nothing is happening. No pressure is being put on here. Dvmir is being allowed to harvest unmolested. Well, now we have some bikes coming in, scattered all over the place. At last, some aggression. Are we going to get harvester killed? One harvester dies. Another should fall. This has got to be such a troll game because I really, if it isn't, then both sides must have been drunk. And now, okay. Now Dvmir has thrown in a towel, so I have utterly no idea what that game was. But hey, it was a good showcase of the new map, so despite the fact Dvmir was going to win that, he decided to fold. He had the eco advantage, Ekko was just had the worst of it throughout, and yet he takes the win. I'm sure that's one he'll feel really good about. Well, okay then, so yeah, new map. First cast of R14. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, you know the score. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitch, send me replays. R12, R11, R13, R14. I don't care. I've got the things for them all. I'll cast them all for you. So yeah, as I say, hope you enjoyed it. Hopefully the next net game on a new map will be a little less weird than that one. And yeah, see you again soon for another BuzzCast.